right. Hello, Micah here from OpenSpace. Greetings. I'm here today to tell you about eclipses in OpenSpace and the content and assets we have available in the eclipse profile. To get this, choose eclipses from your the first dropdown in your launcher instead of default, and then hit start. What you'll get is the similar view that you normally get when you launch OpenSpace, but what you have on the right is what we call our mission panel. This is, you will not get this in the default profile, but you will get this if you pick Eclipses. I'll actually just exit right here and show you that that mission panel is available from the spaceship button. So if you click on that button, that's how you can close it and bring it back. So what is the mission panel? And in this case, it's actually going to teach us about the different eclipses and show us the different eclipses that will happen. So on the left here, we have a timeline, and I'm actually using my scroll wheel, as you can see from the icon, and I'm zooming in on that timeline. And each dot is representing a different eclipse. If I mouse over the dots, I can actually see what type of eclipse they are. And if I click on the dot, I can actually get a little map here that is viewing, that is showing me the eclipse, telling me about when it is, what time. And I'm even getting a button here that says set time, which if I press, will set the time for the eclipse. So now I have set the time for the April eclipse that's upcoming. And I will hit the X to close this panel. Now, what I'm seeing is the Earth, but you'll notice that our daily weather image has actually disappeared, because now we have gone into the future and the weather for April 8th hasn't happened yet. If you're watching this video later, it might have, but during the recording of this video, it hasn't happened yet. So I'm going to now open my scene panel, open up Earth layers, color layers, and turn off our daily weather image and just turn on our Esri World imagery, which is our standard Earth layer without the weather. Now I can close the current focus Earth and I'll X out our scene. So now what you're seeing is the first asset that we have created and made available for the eclipse, which is this Earth Moon shadow. So I'm actually going to zoom out. I'm using the right click here to zoom out. And what we're going to, I'm zooming us out to see the whole Earth Moon system. In case you weren't sure, I can press L here and turn on the label for the moon. And now I'm bringing us to the moon, and we're going to look at what this rendering here. So here we see the moon shadow, and there's actually different components of this rendering. If we go close to the Earth, we'll see smaller, and if we zoom out, we see it's bigger. And these are the different, the penumbra and umbra of the shadow, different components of the shadow. So if I open the scene menu here, open up solar system, planets, Earth, I'll actually find the entry for this Earth Moon shadow. And I can open that up, and there's different parts of it that I can adjust. So as I mentioned, there's the umbral component and the penumbral component. If you want to only show one, you can actually only show one of the two components, but generally we show them both together. And you can also change the colors of the components. So here we'll just use our color picker, and we can change this to be a red color. And if we wanted to change that outline from gray to maybe yellowish. I'm not suggesting that you use these colors, but these just as an example to show how we can change it. So as we can see, this is showing where the eclipse is going to happen on Earth. And it's also showing like where there will be a total eclipse. Now, if I turn that off, I can still see that the eclipse is visualized on Earth with our atmosphere. Right here, it's darker and even darker in the center. And we actually have another component on Earth that we can use to visualize, which is what we call our GeoJSON component. So if I were to now open up Earth here, open up GeoJSON, I'll actually find a list of all the eclipses. Basically, I think we have about 50 years worth of eclipses. And I can find the one that I'm looking at, in this case, total eclipse 2024, April 8th, and I can turn it on. And what we get is the series of lines over the Earth that represent the different portions of the eclipse. And if I go back down and turn on that Earth-Moon shadow, zoom out a little bit, we can actually see that the different areas and the umbral and penumbral components of that actually line up with the different components of the GeoJSON. So now I'll turn this back off. And now if we look at the GeoJSON, there's actually a lot of lines here, and sometimes you might not want to show all these lines. We can open this up by clicking on it and then click on Features. And this will actually show us all the different components of this GeoJSON. So for example, central line, if I turn that off, notice how the blue line disappears from the center. Or maybe these southern and northern magnitude curves, you can see how those two lines disappear around the center. So it's up to you if you want to turn on and off different components and use and show which parts of the GeoJSON you want to show. Now, if we have this on and we turn back on our Earth Moon shadow, now we can look at the Earth, and we can, right now we're running at real time, but we can open our time panel and move time a little faster, maybe even 30 seconds a second. And let's go even faster to 1 minute a second. And we can actually watch this move across and see as the shadow moves across the Earth, we can even maybe go for 5 minutes a second. And we can see that these different components are working together, and we can watch as the path of totality moves across the Earth. So now I'll hit spacebar to pause the time here. And I'm actually going to zoom out a little bit more. And I'm going to show the final component that we have available for showing eclipses. So I'm going to close the GeoJSON, and I'll close the Earth here. And you'll notice here in the Earth system, we have another entry, which is the Earth ecliptic grid. So when I turn that on, and if I zoom out a little bit, we can see that there is a now a radial grid around Earth centered around the ecliptic. And so if I open that up, I can even maybe make it a little easier to see by adjusting the colors, just like we would with trails or any types of grids, anything drawn like this in OpenSpace. If I wanted to, I could adjust the line width and make it thicker. And now I see that basically this Earth ecliptic grid is kind of lining up with the moon. And if I go down here to moon, I can see there's also a moon ecliptic grid. And right now, since we're at the time of the eclipse, the Earth and the moon ecliptic grid are actually very close to each other, and they are aligning with each other. And that is one of the key parts of the eclipse. Most people are just thinking about the direction of the Earth-Moon shadow, but the direction is not the only piece. The alignment of their ecliptics is also very important. We can demonstrate this by just going ahead 1 month in time using the date panel here, and then I'll go back a day. And we can even go back maybe a couple hours. And we can see this time that looks like maybe it would have been an eclipse. Maybe that was too far back. But if we look at this time that looks like it could have been an eclipse, we see that it's not going to be an eclipse because their ecliptics are too far ahead. And so if I can watch this as I progress time, we can see that there will be no eclipse during that time because their ecliptics won't line up. And so there is, like, this is a very important and often overlooked portion of why eclipse will happen between the Earth and the Moon. So now I can just turn those off and just leave us with the Earth-Moon shadow. So those are the components that we have for viewing the eclipse. Be sure to check out the April eclipse and see what happens, and try it out in OpenSpace. Thank you guys, and have a great day.